And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Anivia Control. We're going to be playing a new Anivia deck. Well, it's not really a new Anivia deck, but we're going to be playing a deck with a new card in it, Gluttony. So this is fast spell, kill an ally with last breath to summon a follower from your deck that costs one more. This is a perfect card for Anivia because Anivia, of course, has last breath. And then there's a follower that costs one more that works perfectly whenever you kill your Anivia. So we're going to try to have this combo with Anivia and then Gluttony away the Anivia and put Rekindler into play. That's us living the dream. Besides that, you know, like our deck is just all sorts of removal everywhere and lots of area effect removal. So lots of sweepers. You know, we have the Withering Whales, we have the Avalanches, and we're even playing a copy of the Box. The Box is a card that I haven't really liked in the past. I'm usually underwhelmed whenever I play the Box. It doesn't seem to do as much as you really hope for it to do. But however, 3 damage is really important right now with Aphelios. And there's lots of, you know, all these champions have 3 health. And so I think for the most part, you want to use the Box, even if you just get a 1-for-1, right? Like if they play an Aphelios or an Ezreal or a Misfortune, a Draven, a Jinx, anything like that, just play the Box right away, just kill it, spend 4 mana, and, you know, just have it deal 3 damage. So we're going to be playing one of those and a couple Grasp the Undyings to also do 3 damage. Earlier blocker, Sentry is a great blocker. We can Gluttony away a Sentry and put a Kindly Tavern Keeper into play. It's not great, but we do have that ability if we're just, like, sitting on this Gluttony that's not going to do anything else. Same with, we can turn Aristocrat into Sentry. That's going to be our deck. Lots and lots of removal and using a bunch of Anivias to finish the game. So it's Anivia Control. We're going to go play our 5 games in ranked. All right, Aphelios, Twist of Fate. Because this deck can play a bunch of units. And so, like, this should be a pretty decent Box matchup because they can play a bunch of units. They can go wide, especially in, like, one turn, like, maybe, you know, the Wiggly Burblefishes. Like, they play, like, 2 or 3 Wiggly Burblefish, and then we cast the Box. I kind of want to just keep all 3 of these. Maybe we get rid of this. All right, I'm going to get rid of the Gluttony. I think that if we had, like, 2 other spells that I want to play early on in the game, we could just keep the Gluttony. But not having the other spells, I don't want to keep the Gluttony and then we just draw 2 other like expensive cards and don't get to really ever play anything. Alright, Targaryen says this should be a pretty even matchup. Cool.
Bask in her radiant blessing.
I mean, I could play this Tavern Keeper, but I'm gonna play this Entreat. It's at a point where it's gonna be just kind of free to play it. You know, having Entreat take Anivia out of the deck, you know, one, it doesn't do anything else. Besides that, 2, it does lower the chance of us drawing another Anivia also, because we took it out of our deck.
Safeguard our homes.
It could be tricky having the Box kill stuff.
Never lost a fair game.
We're playing eyes open.
Against the Veil Temple. Maybe not. Because, you know, like the Veil Temple can turn an Aphelios into being 4 health instead of 3 very quickly.
Sunlight guide you, my brethren. Here in your time of need.
I sure do, Rhino. Yep, I am currently at work right now, and I am wearing a tie. So I burned the mana. Because I wanted to see if we could maybe play the Box last turn. I assume they're gonna do other stuff. No? They just don't like doing stuff. How do they stop this? Like, maybe I should have thought about, you know, like, that's what... What are they doing to stop this? Like, they could have, like, the invoke obliterates.
For the homestead.
Yeah, they could have hush.
Back, heretic.
What do you mean? You can see what they invoke sometimes? Does it like really quickly flash on the screen what they invoke? Is the Rekindler not even turned on? It should still be turned on, right? Like, we had a champion die, didn't we? Or no, did it... Oh, it got... Oh. So the Gluttony just didn't even work? Okay, well... I haven't really played Gluttony before. Didn't realize it worked like that. So I should have used Glimpse before it got obliterated. The silent, yeah, it wasn't that it was silent, yeah, so it silenced it, so it didn't have last breath. So the gluttony only sacrifices if it has last breath, I guess. It doesn't just sacrifice it no matter what. I thought it would still just sacrifice it, but then not put a rekindler into play.
Forever watch.
Yeah, so I didn't realize that. I didn't know that it wouldn't work if it was a hush, so yes, I should have cast Glimpse. I do kind of want to vengeance one of those.
A crescent path opens before us.
So I'm learning. These are a lot of cards that I don't play very often. So kind of learning on the job here. I mean, what's a box to put, or like, what does the box do for me? It does 3 damage to this box to put. That's it. It doesn't do a whole lot. It's like, I can glimpse beyond this Anivia and then play a Rekindler, but I'm going to just kill this Twisted Fate. Can we get cheaper spells? Why does everything cost 7 mana? You think I should Vengeance Aphelios? This Twisted Fate's about to level up. I'm killing that thing. You can't box Twisted Fate right now. Or like, yeah, like a super long time ago, I guess it could have. I thought that maybe they would play something else with them having the Veiled Temple and the Twisted Fate was the first card. I thought they were going to be playing a second card, but they didn't. There's no worrying about that. That's forever ago. We have to just do the best that we can. Will this thing, like, fizzle with Glimpse Beyond? I don't know. Let's just see what happens. Will this count as, like, a... Moon weapon cast.
Who's gonna close up?
See as I see.
Okay, still does. So the gluttony fizzles, but that doesn't fizzle. That makes sense. He said sarcastically. So they have 3 fleeting cards in hand. I can't imagine that they want to pass and burn all these fleeting cards. So we can kind of give them some opportunity to play some stuff, because I'm not going to be able to really kill anything here. I can level up my Anivia with the Catalyst, so we can attack and do 2 damage to everything. Thank you.
Nothing escapes my watch.
So they have the stun moon weapon. I guess maybe I need to attack with Anivia because it's the stun moon weapon, but I don't know, we'll see. Wow. They have to have, like, Hush, right? They want me to attack? That has to be Hush. Which I might as well get out of their hand.
Eternal winter.
Safeguard our homes.
Cause Rekindler will still bring Anivia back even if it gets hushed. Alright, maybe it's not Hush. So many cards and so much mana over there. What are they doing? Was that mind meld?
A new era begins.
Was that mind meld? Is mind meld slow? Should be, right? Yeah, it's gotta be a slow speed spell. If I play Vengeance, I only have... No, we just don't need to yet.
Together, brother, we will make death holy.
Because I am worried about... I am worried about that card, Mind Meld. I guess if I would... Yeah, because I mean, we could just Vengeance during combat. We don't have to Vengeance right now. If they have Bastion, we have the... Vile Feast that breaks it up. Alright, so no Mind Meld anymore. They have the deal 3 damage.
Only a fool would enter battle unprepared. Night flowers upon my blade.
And they're just throwing out some things they can just block with.
Return to us.
I like having another Anivia. I like having a Harsh Winds. That really helps. I feel like we're in a really good spot right now. I feel like this game's gotten to a good spot for us. All right, so leveled up Aphelios.
The brighter my light, the stronger your shadow.
It's a 6/6.
In Avarosa's name!
We will resist.
We live here!
I think we're doing just fine. You think the longer the game goes, the better for our opponent? Oh, better for us. Okay. You just mistyped. Yeah, better for us. I may need to, like, I don't know, start vile feasting my own Avarozen Sentry or something. I need to kill these Avarozen Sentries. I need, like, a Ruination. That'd be a good draw. That thing's not a good draw. It's only an 8-7, though. Right now. I guess it's technically going to be 10 power by the time they attack with it. Avarozen Sentry is the worst draw in our deck. So no, so I thought about doing the Vile Feast last turn, but I decided that just kind of go with the Withering Wail. They could have like another one or something like that. I don't know, they play a 3-1.
My strength is yours.
So Vengeance, Entreat, Vile Feast. Yeah, they could have Glimpse Beyond or Gluttony if they want. I will block. I mean, the box just kills that 3-1. It would kill this other box of us too. Like, I can wait till after combat for the box. It doesn't do any damage to those other things.
Until our paths cross once more.
But the Frostbite, that'll do. All right, big overwhelm. We're gonna want those Frostbite. We're gonna want those. Yeah, we don't need Vile Feast, do we? I don't know. Vile Feast, like, isn't bad, but we need Vengeance. We need Frostbite. Vile Feast can, like, pair up with Sentry or Tavern Keeper to kill something bigger, but no, let's just get rid of it. We need to look for better cards.
I have my orders. In position.
Thanks, Apples are a scrap.
They're out there. I'll spot them.
Showed up just in time.
To serve the greater good.
Huh, this Withering Whale's looking kind of good.
That egg, did it move?
In Avarosa's name.
Is that all you got?
I was hoping they weren't gonna block.
Light the signal fires.
At least that one. That block I like. Of course, but I was hoping they weren't gonna block the 2-1.
This'll shake a boom.
This will put me to 18. We'll lose 2, gain heal 3. So heal 1 overall. Okay. Not bad. Troll Chant could be pretty valuable later. That's not too bad.
This'll take the chill off.
And the hope now is they overextend. I have these two blockers. Maybe they play something else before attacking next turn. They overextend into Ruination. That's the hope. Play something else before attacking. Nope. That's not going to happen. So, you can block there. You can block here. You can do that. I want them to play something else than Avalanche, but that's me probably being too greedy. Forever watchful. Probably.
Coming in hot!
Wrapped in cold silence!
A worthy end. And that's also going to make my next turn pretty poor. These fervors. They've been very good.
No more talk.
They've been very good. Six isn't very much life. I had to say, need a mulligan vile fees for better cards earlier, right? Now we're just drawing these vile fees. So playing the Anivia the last turn really hurt me not having anything to do this turn. Okay, so we're going to... Yes, doesn't look good.
We burn, then kindle anew.
Doesn't look good at all.
Blind for Noxus. I have my orders.
Strike them down.
Our best draw step is Anivia. That's our best draw step. I'm kind of doing this in case of grass, but I guess we can just save this 3 spell mana now. Anivia is our best draw step. That allows us to double Hush. That still means we die to double Decimate, though.
The Freljord's Eternal Guardian.
What does that do? Nothing? Yeah, that kind of does nothing.
I will endure.
Very good hand. Good Noxian Fervors. Really good curve. They got me. Alright, playing another aggro deck, which I do like seeing aggro decks. We're gonna hopefully do a better job this time. Now, Catalyst of Aeons is a good card, but I'm not sure if we actually want to play it. Because we are going to want to, like, interact basically every single turn. I'm not sure if I'm going to want Catalyst.
No one's the wise.
This isn't bad.
Everything's in place.
Boom. You know, we'll have Sentry, Tavern Keeper. Try to get them to, you know, extend into Ruination.
See the Nebastian.
This isn't bad. Here. What's my favorite region? I would probably say, if I had to pick one, I would probably say Demacia.
For the Empire.
I like support and challenge.
For the glory of Noxus.
Leave your tracks in the door.
That's what I'd probably choose.
In position. Behind you.
Look out for Reavers. Light the signal fires.
Gotta go with the flow.
All right, so Sprayfin grabs Noction Fervor.
This'll take a chill off. Let's take this outside.
Cool. What do you mean by how expensive is... Oh, by shards? Okay. Thanks, Kordak. Yeah. Alright, 2 out of 5.
I've carved meat bigger than you. Come back next.
So it should be Fervor... Put me down to 12. There we go.
This one's on the house.
It's kind of like a weird spot.
Dead men tell my tale.
All right, so 2 gangplanks gone. Wish we could have got more out of them, but... Lounging lizard.
Off we go.
Alright, so I avalanche, put this down to a 3-3, and then my round start, it turns into a 3-1, and then their round start, it dies. Alright, so that will die. And I'm gonna go ahead and do this now. We already took damage this turn for leveling up Gangplank anyway. And I want to draw a card from Sentry. Another fervor. Stop. All these fervors are destroying us. Gosh, these fervors are destroying us.
Not done yet.
Got another draw in. Looking for Anivia.
Yep, that's my tile.
I mean, it's basically just a draw two. Not the best. Not the best.
Fuse is lit!
That egg, did it move?
Not the best.
Not again.
Aren't any gods here? Just me.
Where's Anivia? So this again is just a draw two if I play this. Which we need two more cards. So these cards aren't gonna do it. Even if you know, even if it's just finding like Grass the Undying or something else, we need two other cards.
Remember the objectives. Make the Empire proud.
Light the signal fire. I promised a bloodbath.
Iron Ballista. Stay at one. But now, you know, at least they don't have the 5-mana unit in play anymore. We got some spiders, but kind of have nothing. Got a Vile Feast.
Keep up.
That should do it. Because that should just be Fervor, so. GG's. So struggling against the burn decks. Normally not what this kind of deck would struggle against. So that's 5 total damage. I can just go to 5. If I Vengeance, they just definitely Fervor immediately. What else could it possibly be? I mean, it could be like a... I guess it could possibly be like a Parlay. All right, so you need to show them, put this in the middle, show them I have a spell, and then be like, no, I don't want to play it. So now maybe they're scared. No, they're supposed to be scared. I tried. And another Anivia Control. So those are two pretty bad losses, honestly. Like the Noxus decks. Like this deck has to beat Noxus. If this deck's not beating Noxus, that's a really bad sign. We saw both of those losses, especially like that last one. You know, like we just had like a bunch of Rekindlers, but Gluttony. So far, it doesn't look like Gluttony can really be played in this deck. That Gluttony's looked really bad so far. Let's see. So mirror, I guess I just want. I mean, Rekindler is good in the mirror if we can find Anivia, but we gotta find Anivia first. Yeah, I agree. The Gluttony's looked really bad. Only, you know, it's small sample, just a few games, but it's looked really bad. Yeah, I wish this Gluttony was a Catalyst of Aeons. That would be great.
They're out there.
I want a Catalyst of Aeons.
In Avarosa's name.
So they'll get that next turn already. Hey, Targaryen King.
A storm approaches. Snow, wind, and ice.
All
rise anew.
We burn, then kindle anew.
A world in perfect stillness.
Alert the villains!
This thing.
What's that noise?
This gives me the mana. You know, I'm saving 3 spell mana for this next turn, so we can also have Anivia plus Gluttony.
Forever watchful.
These old eyes still see far and clear.
For my homeland.
I guess I should be attacking with the 1/1s. Maybe I shouldn't Gluttony right now.
Light the signal fires.
If I Gluttony, they have the ability to kill. They just attack. They kill my other 0/1. Yes, the egg dies. If I cast Gluttony, the egg dies. But might as well. It does take a Rekindler out of my deck, which a Rekindler is a good draw.
Be reborn.
Return to us.
I bring the storm.
Come to the light.
You have to get me out of here.
Join the conflagration.
Blow winds and crack your cheeks.
No, I don't want to kill their Rekindler. For their, like, Harrowings and... I don't know if they'll have, like, Miscall. I don't really want to have them have a bunch of, like, dead Rekindlers and Anivias and stuff. They'll eventually die anyway. There's not really that much difference between, between the two things. I'd rather just not have that Rekindler be dead right now. Man, this mirror match is kind of miserable. You just can't play anything. It's just like nothing is good to play ever. Alright, they get to kill this.
What will you have?
Alright, so they've played a couple of catalysts, they get to level up first. I don't think I play... If I play Rekindler and they play Ruination, that's very bad for us, I think. Maybe it's not, because then we hit Harrowing next turn. I don't know. I glimpsed the Tavern Keeper to play around their Vile Feast. Because if I would have tried glimpsing my spider, and they could just have Vile Feast for that. And also, yeah, it's a good blocker. You know, it doesn't kill things, it just dies anyway. I know I am not doing every single move correctly in this game. But see, this is why I didn't kill their Rekindler, by the way. I can certainly tell you I'm not doing everything correctly. This seems like a kind of mirror match that you need to play a bunch and really have a really good feel for, you really need to have a good feel for your deck. And therefore the opponent's deck as well.
For my homeland.
Because, they're the same deck. This definitely seems like a mirror match that favors the more experienced player. That's A. B, with them having the Catalyst of Aeons, they just have sped up much faster than me. And that's been pretty big. I attacked to get rid of that egg. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know exactly every single line. I don't know what's the upside or downside of attacking if I'm not supposed to attack there. I don't know.
Eternal winter.
Yeah, they could have blocked their things and killed our Anivias, and then they could have attacked and killed the Anivias, but I'm not sure if it's really like that bad. It just clears up. Just kind of clears up room for like Harrowing to bring back more Anivias. None of these look like good options. But also not doing anything doesn't look like a good option. I don't know what to do.
I bring the storm.
That light flickers.
Yeah, they're definitely attacking. Yeah, but yeah, that they would attack if I would have passed, they would definitely attack.
I will endure.
Such naivete.
So I've had one tavern keeper die. Yeah, so that one tavern keeper is annoying. So now we get three Anivias. Where with that egg there, I would have only gotten two. Now we get three.
This is our time. The Freljord's eternal guardian.
I'll get two, or no, I just get one. Yeah, we don't want to do that. I guess I just attack.
Snow, wind, and ice.
Come from the dark.
Just like attack and withering wail afterwards. And see if, you know, basically see, do they have another harrowing? Maybe they don't have another harrowing. I think I probably will. T says don't clear the eggs. I mean, the worst case scenario with clearing the eggs is they have harrowing and then those things are Anivias again anyway. So like, worst case scenario is those are just Anivias, right? Like there's, it's only upside clearing the eggs, right? It's not like it gets, if I don't clear them, they're just Anivias anyway. If I do clear them, then maybe they're still Anivias. So I don't really see why I wouldn't. Like, they're gonna get... Those Anivias are dead anyway, right? Like, so if they have harrowing... they'd still get those Anivias anyway. So if I go Ruination and then Avalanche, then we don't have any Anivias. Do I possibly go just Gluttony and then Ruination and then hope they don't have Avalanche? Because then I have the attack token next and I'd have four. I guess I'd only have three. I'd have three Anivias. So no, the Gluttony doesn't make any sense. That's what I was trying to think of, if like Gluttony would make sense to play first before Ruination. Oh, I have another Harrowing. Okay, good. Yeah, so yeah, we definitely do this. I think that Withering Wail was good to do. Or I guess I should have done Avalanche last turn, and then I would have had Withering Wail this turn. No, you don't have mana for Withering Wail this turn. So everything worked out just fine. How it's supposed to. So they've cast two Harrowings.
Nothing escapes my watch.
This is about to be my second. I think I wait. Because this is like my last go of it. So if I Harrowing and they Ruination and then, then kill my things, that's my last go. I think I need to like Harrowing on the end of their turn.
For the homestead. The signal fires.
So they have 9 in hand. Okay, that card's cool. It's cool. So they got 10 in hand.
The spirit of winter awakens.
So they have 7 mana, so they can't Ruination. So I think waiting on that Harrowing was really good. I think that we kind of set them up where they didn't have the Ruination to be able to respond to my Harrowing. I think that worked out perfectly. There we go. The GGs. We set them up.
They're out there. I'll spot them.
Stop.
I bring the storm.
Such naivete.
Look out for Reavers.
Well, they go to 1. Okay, well. I guess the game's not over yet.
Alert the village.
I thought it was whenever they did the GG thing, but I guess not yet. Vile Fees, why couldn't I have you last turn? You would have been great with my 3 mana to take down Anivia. I mean, Gluttony, my board was too full for Gluttony. Gluttony wouldn't have done anything. I couldn't play Gluttony.
For my homeland. I will endure.
Alright, so they have 6 mana left. We gotta kill both of these things. And then also kill the eggs. And I have a Gluttony to kind of protect. Cool. cool. No Vile Feast. So it's not game yet, because it just Withering Wail keeps them alive. I can't really Gluttony. Oh, no Withering Wail. Okay. Couldn't really Gluttony first, because it's just too easy to answer. And finally, we won.
The cycle is complete.
Alright, I'm glad we're playing against Pyroburn again, so we can see how it goes a second time. And also, it won't be a match that will take 30 minutes, so that's also good. So I also like that. I guess we have to mulligan this. If I had one of these three cards, I would have kept any of these three cards. I would have kept those, and I would have kept like a Vengeance, because as we saw last time, like Gangplank, Jack the Winner, those are cards that we got to be able to kill right away. So like the Vengeance is important. It's just I didn't have like another one of these spells. Like if I would have had any of these, I would have kept Vengeance and like Vengeance and Avalanche, or Vengeance and Grasp, or Vengeance and Withering Wail. So I did play all three Noxious Fervors last time. This is the card that needs to change, I think, in our deck. This card needs to go. This, like, we have the two Gluttonies. I think there should be one other Grasp and one other Catalyst of Aeons. This is the card that keeps losing us games, because it's just so useless.
No prey, no pay.
Well, Gluttony, I just called you useless. We're gonna see how useless you are.
This'll take the chill off.
I'll show the hunters.
Love ya.
Keep that misfortune from attacking.
I have my orders.
So probably going Withering Wail, but I'm not going to just cast Withering Wail right now first. I'm going to see if they play anything else that can attack. Also, I know that I'm taking one damage from... by waiting, I take a damage from the Saboteur. Knows me now.
I'll show the hunters.
So I can play the box. Okay, so it's either... So the box kills these two, and then I block the 2/1, or I Withering Wail and kill these two, and then block the 2/2. Which one am I going to want later? Probably the box.
Let's talk about your death.
I think the box is probably going to be more useful later against these 5/5s. Why didn't you just play that also, and then attack? Then I could have boxed away that too. Because against a bunch of 5/5s, we have like box plus avalanche, right? Like I think these match up better against Jack the Winners and Gangplanks, so that's why I saved this.
The flames, not the depths can claim me. A splinter. Let him bleed out. I've got fleet bigger than you.
Why couldn't you just play something else? Let me avalanche.
Let's talk about
your... Alright, so this we go to 8, this we go to 9.
Let's talk about your tech.
That's really not much of a difference. Like that's 1 point different to kill this Gangplank.
water is mine and mine alone. Cowards!
I have three options, three realistic options. Draw Anivia, play Anivia. Play one Avalanche and then play another Avalanche afterwards, or play Catalyst and then play one Avalanche.
If they don't break, they'll burn.
Gross.
The few for the many.
I really wish I didn't mulligan the Vengeance. Why can't I? Yeah, I need Vengeance. All right, so that's, I think that's a good lesson learned. I think you got to keep Vengeance because, you know, like Gangplank, I think needs Vengeance.
Here in your time of need.
Yeah, you need Vengeance. That's the other card that needs Vengeance.
For my homeland.
Try me.
All right, so I think good lesson learned that keep Vengeance in this matchup.
A worthy end.
Go look for Vengeance.
I will be reborn.
We have just drawn so many Rekindlers and Harrowings in these two games against this Pirate Burn deck. We've had hands filled with those two cards. Alright, so we did find Vengeance, but no more Nexus Healing for us.
Eternal Winter! Bury all in stone. Cover me, Crackshot. You got it, Captain.
Yeah, I guess now I have to Ruination. Alright, so 2 and 3.
Warm hearts and hot soup.
This deck's missing something. Okay, so of course, as I talked about, I wasn't very impressed with Gluttony in those games. I also was not impressed with the box. I felt that there's twice we had the box that it would have just been a better card if it was Grasp the Undying, both times. Like, the two times that we kind of almost cast the box. So I know you, like, have to be able to kill your own Anivia for, like, Rekindler Harrowing and stuff. I guess you have to be able to kill your own Anivia, but I don't know. I've never really liked like the three Glimpse Beyonds, and now we have three Glimpse Beyonds and two Gluttony, so we have like five cards that, you know, don't do anything until super late in the game, like whenever you have like your six mana champion in play and then more mana. Is it possible to play like less Glimpse Beyonds in this deck? Like, can like some of these Glimpse Beyonds just be like Chronicler of Ruins that you can actually just like play against regular decks and have a blocker? And, you know, you can have that. It could reset a sentry. It can just do stuff like that. But then, you know, you can still kill an Anivia. Like, is that something you can do? Like, I'm not saying take out all Glimpse Beyonds and play Chronicler of Ruin, but there's definitely times where it would be, sure be nice just to have a 3-3. I don't know. I think definitely needs some better better answers and options against that kind of burn deck, but it's also a learning experience for me. You know, like I haven't really played this kind of deck too much. Playing that, like, definitely the last game I should have kept Vengeance in my hand. I think that would have certainly helped, because imagine, like, the turn, like, with if I would have had Vengeance from my opener, if I would have kept it, then on turn 5, whenever they played the Gangplank that leveled up and did a whole bunch of damage, you know, took me from, like, 14 to, like, you know, not very much. If I had a Vengeance, just a Vengeance, that Gangplank, you know, I could have had my 3-1 Tavern Keeper block their 3-2. And we would have been fine. You know, like, I had to use, like, the box to do, like, a little bit of damage to the Gangplank, but not even that much. Because then I could have had, like, the box later on for whenever they had, you know, like, Misfortune and the 1-2. You know, like, we could have had that box later on. I think that whole game would have been a whole lot different if I would have kept Vengeance. That's a good thing to kind of learn. Okay, you've been playing 2 Glimpse and 1 Chronicler. Yeah, I like that. Because getting a hand filled with, like, Glimpses and Gluttonies and stuff, I didn't like that. So I think, you know, just some different... This is a kind of deck that you should... do need to play a good amount to learn, because when you play control decks like this, where your deck is just filled with answers and you're always, like, answering whatever threats your opponent's playing, that is something that, and this is true with Anivia Control and true with just control decks in general, these kind of decks are decks that you may not have as much success with right away. So whenever you pick up a control deck, whether it's Anivia Control or it's some other control deck, where you have a deck with a whole lot of answers and you're always, like, playing removal spells, that kind of deck you may not have the best win rate with right away, because it's the kind of deck that you need to learn. You really need to learn exactly what, you know, like, how your opponent's playing, like, what kind of cards they have, what kind of answers you need for those cards. You know, because I think that just playing, like, those 2 Pirate Burn games, you know, I learned a lot from those, and I'd be more confident moving forward in that matchup. And just the more you kind of play those, the more you can kind of see of, like, what, you know, what cards you need to use when, what cards you need to keep because you need for different scenarios and stuff like that. So if you play a control deck that is a deck with a lot of answers and you don't have the best record right away, that's okay. But, you know, just keep learning during your games. You know, you may have, like, different threats that sneak through the cracks and get that extra damage on you that ends the game. But, you know, keep learning and you know, you'll get better with it. All right, but that's all I got here for Anivia Control. Also, those of y'all on YouTube, you know, always, of course, hit that like button, but please leave those comments. Let me know what you think of Gluttony. Have you been playing this kind of deck, and do you really like Gluttony? Am I underrating it? What do you think of Glimpse Beyond, Chronicler of Ruin, that kind of stuff? Yeah, I'd love to hear, like, what do you think of the matchup against the Pirate Burn? Love to hear that kind of stuff. But that's all I got here for this one. So that's Anivia Control. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.